Hello. Now I know what you were about to say.
Crypto Daily, where the hell is a funny intro?
A lot of people rich. So what was the greatest strength of the market in that many people were seemingly made rich, if not millionaires, if not more, overnight?
FBI, open up!
But today I thought we'd do something a little bit different. We're going to be comparing the difference in music from December of 2017 to July this year.
This is legendary. Threw my job out of the window, a great montage. Out of my comfort zone, and I just don't give a damn. YouTube is a platform, and I'm just trying to get in. Saying I'm with this band. People acting out of pocket, trying to grab up on the gains. 100 emails in my inbox, and they all got a plan. And they all need a friend. I've been buying since this year, true story, man. I feel just like a rock star.
Not bad. Now let's see. August 5th, 2018.
Yesterday.
What happened yesterday?
All my shit coins hit their ATH.
Time to sell.
Now I held too long in price decayed.
No.
Oh, I believe in yesterday's sudden. They aren't half of what they used to be.
What a difference just a few short months make. Let's move on, shall we? All right, so looking at the market today, we seem to have had some sort of influx of money and things are looking pretty good. Market cap is a quarter trillion. It's nice to say quarter trillion. What I find interesting is if we have a look at the market cap, look at the past 3 months or so, we can see that the highest highs and the lowest lows aren't so different anymore. And the higher the highs, that size of a gap between them is getting smaller and smaller. We're starting to see almost a straight line now. We are at the most stable Bitcoin's ever been for like 2 or 3 years at this point in time. I believe this is good for new investors because, one, they're not watching their money disappear right before their eyes, and second, this gives potential people who are new to the markets the time needed to get invested fundamentally, not just financially. Also helps little things like the SEC's ruling of an ETF for Bitcoin. A widely volatile Bitcoin as a reason against an ETF just is no longer a valid criticism, not lately, anyway. Now, I have a confession to make. I have a holiday booked that I booked quite a while back, and it's next week going to Australia. I am still going to be making videos, but I fly out on Sunday and it's like a 24-hour flight, so it's going to be at least Wednesday maybe before I get a video out, unfortunately. I did want to do a studio tour on Instagram. I kind of don't have time. Let's do it now. I'll show you around my house if you want to see it. So I turned on the lights in here. It's a little bit brighter, but yeah, this is what I see when I film. Let's get this chair out of the way. This is a, what chair is this? This is a Herman Miller. This is a Shure SM7B, and it's currently hooked up to this mixer over here. This is a Yamaha MG10XU. I kind of got it so I can keep my voice at a certain level using a compressor. It doesn't work too well, but there you go. The studio lights are activated by a switch on my phone, which is pretty cool. Got my computer over here. But that's an 8700K processor, 32 gigs of RAM, a 1080 mini graphic card because it came from a smaller computer. As you can see, when you look down, you don't see any wires apart from one, which I need to sort out for the mixer, but everything else is still hooked up here. It looks really bad, but you don't see this unless you actually look up. This curtain, you open it, nothing. This is a sound panel over there. You open this curtain, and there's the door. So I feel like I'm in a cave. Oh yeah, and I got this wall painted green simply because it's much easier to deal with. All right, not bad, but let me show you my other place where I spend a lot of my time.
All right, this is my other setup. Now it doesn't look so good, but it is incredibly functional. I will give it that. Very, very functional. We've got the TV on the wall there. All the wires are hidden, which is pretty cool. Now this computer looks a lot nicer than the other one. We got these glowing lights. We got a full-size graphics card in there. But that's the gaming rig. Then we got this lovely view outside.
I've thought about coming out here to maybe film some stuff, but I don't have anything to sit on, so I'm gonna leave that for a while. But yeah, not a bad green screen. Is this possible to be green screened? Perfect. All right, let's head back in. Bedrooms that way. Studio, excuse the boxes, in here.
All right, now in the next episode, I'd like to do a Q&A. So if you would like to leave me your questions on Twitter or Instagram, you can ask me anything that's crypto related or otherwise, anything that's sensible or otherwise, and I'll react to it. Okay, what was I going to talk about today? All right, there's a few things I wanted to talk about today, including a Bitcoin Cash developer finding the mother of all bugs, the ability to double spend, not on Bitcoin Cash, but on Bitcoin. Now, this bug was caught on the testnet of Bitcoin, not actually on the mainnet, and now it's been patched. It took like an hour to fix, as far as I understand it, so it wasn't actually done on the mainnet. However, the point is that if this was pushed over onto the mainnet, that this type of manipulation might have been possible, where you take an arbitrary amount, an arbitrary number of Bitcoin that you already have, and essentially duplicate it. That's a very dumbed down explanation of the whole process, but if you want to check out Bitcoin double spend on Google, knock yourself out. Most nodes on the Bitcoin core testnet are no longer vulnerable. And just basically the moral of the story is, hey, Bitcoin Cash developers aren't all demons. Not that I think they are personally. Bitmain is in the news majorly today with seemingly being made official that they are indeed going to pursue sales of the company in an IPO. Now, why am I reporting this? Why should you care? Well, it definitely does have an impact on cryptocurrency mining. These guys have pretty much got a monopoly on the hardware mining sales, as well as hash power, although not as big a monopoly. But as far as Bitcoin Cash USD valuations as well, it is kind of important, the success of this company, seeing how they bag hold so much. But the details we can glean from their 438-page prospectus, thank goodness for Reddit, includes Q2 2018 profits announcements, or lack thereof. Welcome to the club, Bitmain. Now, they have been extremely profitable in the past, even as recently as Q1 2018. However, Q2 paints a completely different picture, and with numbers like these, no business could continue for long. We're talking $400 million net loss on top of $500 million, which was spent on new hardware chips, a new fabrication method, which all failed. Now, it's not entirely uncommon when you're going with a new and unrefined method of creating these, but that has got to hurt. So near $900 million loss in the last few months alone. On top of that, they're sitting on a giant mound of Bitcoin Cash, which is illiquid at this stage, when you're talking about those figures at least, and over $1 billion worth of mining hardware, which they anticipated needing to have the inventory for to meet the demand in sales. But of course, that demand isn't there. They now need to either sell for a loss to shift that inventory or risk pricing out potential customers. However, it isn't actually all bad for them, unfortunately. I don't know why I hate Bitmain so much. Actually, I do, but still, I don't like monopolies. They have raised, and they will likely continue to raise, a ton of money through new investors. They have new mining operations opening up across North America, where hydropower, the locations where that can be found. If they can just curb their mismanagement, and let's be honest, straight up gambling on the occasions, then they'd be just fine, most likely, until Samsung releases a new, more refined, efficient miner. That's why I'm primarily not so interested in buying Bitmain shares myself, even if I could. They've pretty much peaked. We have so many competitors pouring in hundreds of millions of dollars into new efficient miners, while Bitmain hasn't been able to produce a new miner since the Antminer S9 years ago. It's a great time to sell off your company, really. Just like one great, like, I don't want to say it. Like and sub it up. I will be back probably Wednesday, maybe Thursday, depending on what's going on.
I will do a meetup in Australia for sure. I'm in the Sydney area. I will let you know more details when I do. Thank you. Bye-bye.